Hello, Tampa Bay and the surrounding communities. It is me again, Al McCray, with TampaNewsAndTalk.com. We are Tampa Bay's last place news. You heard me right, we're Tampa Bay's last place news. We don't have no roving reporters or helicopters overhead, or we're just last place. Might as well be honest about it. We have a variety of guests on our shows, you name it, attorneys, cops, regular people, government officials, community people. For many years, I've had questions about trust. Like, what is a trust? So I invited a trust attorney, Stratton Smith. I was getting mixed up. Can you say it for him, please?
Stratton Smith.
I have a Negro dialect, so sometimes it doesn't come out right, you know?
I never noticed.
You know? Okay. He is a trust attorney, and we're going to spend some time discussing a trust. All the ins and outs of a trust. Thanks for coming. Such a short notice.
Thank you for inviting me, Al.
Just what is a trust?
A trust is sort of like a corporation in many respects.
Mm-hmm.
You place assets in this entity that is a separate legal entity, and the idea is it will be managed the way you want it to be managed during your lifetime for your benefit, perhaps for your spouse's benefit too,
mm-hmm.
and then after your death, managed for your children's benefit, or grandchildren, or even if you don't have no children, or your children are doing so well they don't need it, maybe for charitable purposes.
Who owns the trust? Who actually owns the trust?
At the time you create it, really most of the time you do. You have created it. You are the grantor or settlor of the trust. And you have a degree of control over it. In many trusts, they are allowed to be terminated at your wish. If you die, however, or become incapacitated and have not terminated it, it continues for the benefit of others. It will be controlled by people called trustees, people you have selected, or companies that you selected.
Can they vote me out, my own trust?
If you're the trustee and perhaps you have become a victim of Alzheimer's and you're incompetent to manage the trust, yes, you could be removed by your own beneficiaries.
But what if I have my brother and my cousin as trustees and we have fallen out? Can they vote me out?
Legally, no. Not unless you've given them the power to do so in the trust, which you're not likely to do.
Oh, okay.
A trust is an elaborate contract, very specialized contract. And you could give persons the power to remove you under any circumstances, but most of the time that isn't done.
But these people who I appoint, they have a vote on the affairs of the trust?
Not during your lifetime while you're controlling it, no.
So I can make any decision I want to with the money?
Most of the time that's true.
With no oversight from anybody?
Not really. If you lose your mental faculties, then they can step in and say, Al's lost it. He can't handle it anymore. We need to be in control. Where would you do that? You'd have to go to a court. They'd have to prove to the court that Al had lost his abilities.
So unless that happens, I take all my money, throw it in a trust, I'm protected from creditors, and my trustees, they have no say-so how I spend the money?
They're not going to be trustees until you are not acting as your own trustee.
Oh, I see. So why do I have them then?
You have them there because they're going to handle it if you become incapacitated or you die.
Only reason?
Only reason.
And how many can you have? Is there a certain amount you got to have?
You can have one, two, three, four trustees, however many you want. My strong suggestion, though, is you go back to a statement you made, Al. You said it's protected from my creditors. Not during your lifetime, it's not.
It's not?
No. It's not protected from your creditors during your lifetime.
So why do I have it then?
Well, what are you going to do with your assets after your death? you're not going to do anything with them.
Well, to tell you the truth, I haven't thought that far.
Well, nobody likes to think about dying, but we all get out of this world in the same way we die.
Mm-hmm.
As a result, if you leave your assets through a will to your family, you're going to spend a great deal of time and perhaps money in having your estate run through probate.
Okay.
That's called estate administration. And the court is known as the probate court. So people think of it as probate.
And they decide what to do. They decide.
Your will has told them what to do, but they have to go through a series of steps before it can go to your family. If it's in a trust, it has very limited administrative expense and delay. By comparison, you have almost no probate cost whatsoever. And it starts to be managed for the benefit of your beneficiaries as you chose them.
Because the fund's already there.
Yes, sir, that's correct. Now, the trust is a taxable entity after your death.
Let's say the lotto tonight is, what, $350 million. I'm going to catch it next Wednesday night, okay?
Good.
So what do I do?
I'll be right there to help you.
So I take my ticket, I create a trust first, put all the money in the trust. How do I get money out of it to spend?
You're your own trustee most of the time. If it's that much money, you'll probably want a professional trustee who will do the investing for you.
So there's no control on what I can take out and not take out?
Well, if you have designed a trust agreement that says that Al can take out whatever he wants to, then there really is no control.
That money is taxable when it comes out?
Well, you've already paid tax on it.
On the lotto part.
When you won it, you paid income tax on that. The trust didn't buy the ticket.
Okay.
You didn't see a trust walk down the street and buy that ticket.
But I must put the trust name on the back of the ticket.
Not necessarily. You really cash it in and have them pay the check to the trust.
It can be on my name, everybody know about it. And give the money to the trust.
Yes, sir. Either way, it's going to be treated as having been given to the trust, and you're going to pay income tax on it because you're the one who won it.
Is money come out of trust that's taxable if you earn interest off an investment from the trust?
Well, let's say you have $1 million in your trust, and the $1 million is invested in corporate bonds returning 5%.
Mm-hmm.
That 5% is the income you're making. And at 5%, that's $50,000 a year. You'll pay income tax on that $50,000 a year. The smart thing to do, based on the tax laws as we currently have them, is to distribute all the income out to yourself. If you fail to do that, the trust will pay an income tax at one of the highest rates you've ever seen. 39.6% is the beginning rate.
You talk like the trust is a living, breathing person.
The trust is in many respects, but you're controlling it. It's like it's like a corporation. It's a separate legal entity and has its own tax bracket.
So what's the advantage of a trust over me going and forming a corporation in Delaware and giving the money to the corporation in Delaware? The advantage.
Well, now that's a question we'll have to spend a lot of hours talking about because that's very complicated. We actually use limited liability companies in conjunction with trusts to make it simpler to hold things like land, make it easier to, for example, have a business that then can be transferred into the trust after the death. And these are the tools we use to simplify the process of living and the process of dying.
When I get my net of $350 million, probably around, I don't know, $198 million, where is that money kept at if I give it to the trust? Where did it actually deposit it at?
Let's say that you go to one of our fine trust companies here in Tampa. We have many of them. And they decide to invest it for you, and they go over what the investments they think are a good choice for you based on your age and your wishes.
But what amount is it guaranteed for the bank go out of business?
Well, the bank's insured. The trust. This is a trust company, too. It's not necessarily the bank. They have a complete separate insurance.
So if it's more than $250,000, if it's a trust company bank?
Well, it's a trust company. The trust company is investing it in the securities market. Maybe perhaps it's lending mortgage money to people.
Well, who guarantees them? Who protects my money with the trust?
If you went down to one of the big national companies that does investing and says, I have this money, I'd like you to invest for me, what's your guarantee with them?
I guess nothing beyond $250.
It's a similar situation with a trust. The really? Trust is, in fact, operated by people who are skilled in making investments. So they know how to make investments and where to go. You decide on what you want as a risk factor. They literally will sit down with you and figure out what risk you can tolerate.
So my money is no more safer with them than the bank down the street.
That's right.
Wow.
Except it's professionally managed by skilled investment people.
Well, I think about Bernie Madoff. He made off real good.
Well, Bernie was selling an empty box.
Okay.
And he sold a lot of those boxes that were empty, but he took cash for them.
Some better off forming multiple trusts and keeping these trusts no more than $250K to be covered by the government.
Very possible. Now, you can go to a bank and you can deposit the money in the bank and get interest on that money.
Mm-hmm.
But the interest rates that banks pay are not as high as you could get by having perhaps a better corporate bond or even a government bond. So it's possible that you could make more money not being in a bank. Yes, you take some risk, but there's no reward without some risk.
Do some banks insure more than the federal government limit?
I know of none that do. They are all dependent upon the federal government.
I thought trust mean your money was safer than a regular account you have in a trust.
Well, trust is a description of a type of document.
That's all it is.
Yes, sir. And a trust company is someone who acts as a trustee professionally for people who have such documents and want their money to be managed.
What scares me, they can go under also. They can just file bankruptcy and go under.
I don't know of any trust company that's done that hasn't been taken over by another trust company. I know of no one that's lost money with a trust company. And somebody may call in and say, Al, that guy doesn't know what he's talking about. There were several trust companies that had this happen to them. But I know of none.
I think I feel safer creating maybe 100 different smaller trusts of $300,000 each.
And investing your money in a bank.
Yeah, but I have the FDIC protection on each account.
That's true.
What are some of the most common trust agreements, the most common ones?
They're generally something called a living trust. Mm-hmm. A living trust is really a misnamed document. Because if you create a trust during your lifetime, that is a living trust. When someone says a living trust, what they mean is the trust is amendable, revisable, and capable of being terminated at any time. So if you created a living trust, it would be a revocable trust. Therefore, it could be amended and revised any way you wanted to make it during your lifetime
and
your capacity.
I can change trustees also.
Yes, sir. So the living trust is very flexible. In the living trust, you have the right to all the income most of the time. It's rare that I've ever seen a trust that doesn't do that. And at the same time, it's your death. The trust will administratively say where the money's going to go, to which of your children, and in which fashion.
But can my girlfriend meet her fallout after, I don't know, 5 years? She's one of my trustees. Can she protest me taking her off the trust?
Well, she can say anything she wants to, but you have the right to remove her.
But she has no legal justification authority?
No. Now, as I say, this is technically, if you were incompetent,
mm-hmm.
your Alzheimer's had gotten
so bad. Well, she probably says that about me now, okay?
Well, we know different. But again, they'd have to establish that you were incompetent and that you didn't have, therefore, the capacity to remove her as a trustee.
Okay, can a trust be sued for actions that I commit? I have a car wreck, for example.
You have an automobile accident and you have money in a living trust.
Yes.
What you're asking is, could a John Morgan lookalike collect more money than your insurance would pay from your trust?
Correct.
And the answer is yes.
So I have to form a company in the middle between the trust and me and my car. Let my car be owned by ABC Incorporated, own my car, and ABC Incorporated be owned by the trust.
That's a possibility. Of course, remember, you're the driver, so you're still personally responsible for what you do with the car.
Okay. So what protection do I have with my money if I can get sued anyway?
You could create an irrevocable trust.
Okay.
If you did, you can build in protections that keep it from being as subject to collection. And we have, so far, I believe we now have 31 states that have self-settled asset protection trusts.
And what does all that mean?
It means that I can go to South Dakota, Delaware, Nevada, or several other places, and I can create a trust in those jurisdictions. And I can put my assets in there. And as long as I don't have creditors at that moment when I create it that I owe money to, then that trust is protected from anybody ever collecting from it.
Because it was formed out of state?
Because they had laws in that state that say that the trust is protected.
But it's the same amount of protection of the $250,000 FDIC amount.
No, we're talking about collection from a creditor who's trying to collect it from Al. If that trust were created in one of those jurisdictions where it's protected, they can't collect it from you.
But all these Morgans lookalikes out there these days, would they have just as much trouble?
Well, they could come attack the trust and spend a lot of your time defending it, but they lose. These are very, very strong kinds of trusts.
So the trust puts the money in a trust bank who specializes in trusts?
Yes.
And for your knowledge, a trust has never gone under, a trust bank?
To my knowledge, I've never heard of a trust company going under.
So you have five type basic trusts. You have irrevocable, revocable?
Revocable and irrevocable.
Irrevocable.
Those are the two kinds generally. There's a variation on that, which would be the self-settled asset protection trust, which is available in a number of states. And you can, even though you're a Florida resident, you can go to one of those states, have an attorney there prepare that trust, deposit your resources with a trust company that would manage them for you. And those assets are protected from creditors.
I mean, you're wasting your time trying to get money from me.
Yes. Now, of course, there is the other problem. If it's all in the trust, how is Al going to be able to live?
Yeah, my next question, yes.
Well, if the trust pays for Al's mortgage on his home, and it's a Florida homestead, it's protected from creditors.
And if the trust pays me a stipend, is that taxable? I mean, attachable?
Attachable. The stipend probably would not be paid to you directly.
I mean, how would I get it?
You need a new hat. So the trust says, here, Al, take this prepaid credit card and go buy yourself a new hat.
With $30,000 on the credit card.
Or however much.
You say the trust says, that'll be me saying to myself.
You're not the trustee. Remember, in this instance, you should not be the trustee because you've got people who want to collect from you.
Okay.
So you have another person or entity,
that
like a trust company, who runs the trust for you.
But
and
what's keeping
you
them
call
from
them up and say, I need a new hat and I'm going to buy some new clothes. So I would like to have a prepaid credit card that has this much of a line on it so that I can buy stuff that I need.
But isn't that a big risk? The other person may drain the trust for their own benefit?
Well, who would be the other person? That's a bank or an institution. They're insured against theft.
So trust in this case not be my brother or ex-girlfriend or a child?
It could, but for a larger amount of money, you probably don't want that. How experienced or knowledgeable are they in managing money? Well, in being sensitive to taxation.
Well, they're very good at going to West Shore Mall.
Well, you don't want them to have a prepaid credit card.
So, what's the most common trust?
Living trust.
What does it cost to set up a trust?
For a living trust, along with the ancillary documents, and we should talk about that mm-hmm. too, the trust is probably going to be somewhere around $2,000 to $3,000, depending on how complex
it is. That is it.
That's all there is to that part. But you also need a will, just in case you were holding that winning lotto ticket and you want to make sure it gets to the trust. Mm-hmm. You also need something like a durable power of attorney.
Mm-hmm.
And the reason it's called durable is it's a power of attorney that gives somebody broad powers to manage your resources. It's durable because even if you become incapacitated, that power of attorney is still good.
Okay.
Most powers of attorney cease to be able to be used if you're incapacitated. It's not usable after your death, however. And that person you are giving the confidence to that they will manage your resources is going to use that power of attorney to take care of needs you may have if you are incapacitated.
Well, I hear the cash register. Ka-ching, 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 ka-ching. So where are we now, at $1 million?
Well, that these ancillary documents are generally all done at one time, so it has some efficiencies. And probably for the ancillary documents I'm speaking of, you're looking at an additional $500 to $750.
That is it?
Yes, sir.
You know, I called around for various trust attorneys, and I was quoted like 3% or a minimum of $3 million.
That's for trust companies.
That would they charge and say that for you?
The trust companies will manage a trust. Usually I see the trust companies charging somewhere around 1.25% annually for managing your money.
Even if you don't make that much return.
Well, that's true.
So how do you get out of a trust? How do you kill a trust?
Remember, you are in control of this trust if it's a living trust. You can revoke it anytime you want to.
So I write a check to myself for $200 million and bankrupt the trust, that's the end of it?
Well, you don't bankrupt it. It's your money. So you write the check, if you're the trustee, to yourself, put it in the banks you want to put it in, and the trust is empty. Now, if you want to revoke the trust, you will just sign a document and say, I hereby revoke my trust.
Before I met you, I thought this was a lot more complicated, trust.
It can be more complicated than you could possibly imagine. It depends on what you're trying to do.
Well, hide money. you know, hide money, you know?
Well, the best way to hide money is to...
Not have it. Not have none.
If you can't find it, they can't be taken from you.
So I can buy a house in the name of the trust.
If the trust has the power to allow you to reside in a Florida home as your homestead, not only can you do that, but it's homestead protected under the laws of Florida.
If the trust has the power, but I'm the one who's calling the shots, right?
Sure.
So I can not have the power or have the power? I mean,
well, if the trust says that Al can buy a homestead and reside in that as his homestead and have all the tax benefits and all the creditor protections that the Florida law provides.
Is that bylaw you set up when you do the trust? You write these rules down going
yes,
into
sir.
The trust?
Absolutely.
You can modify or amend them?
Yes, sir. Sure can. We've had a new tax law come out, and we're doing a lot of modification for our clients' trust because this new tax law changes a lot of things we had to do in the past, makes us do them differently.
Mm-hmm. So if I catch the lotto, I'm going to put the winning ticket under my mattress, and I'm going to, because you probably sleep when I call you at midnight on Saturday. So do I set up a trust that Monday or wait till I cash in the ticket?
We've had a lot of people who, between the time they bought the lottery ticket and the time that they realized they had just won, somehow had family partnerships that all co-owned that lottery ticket. Now, if they don't admit to the IRS that they formed that partnership verbally after they realized they won, mm-hmm. it gets taxed to all those partners.
Really?
Not just to the one person.
Now, how long?
Now, have I ever done that? No. Do I know that people have done that? Yes. There have actually been a couple who shot their mouths off at the wrong time, and the end result was the IRS did not like it.
Okay. Wow. Well, you know, I wish you had more time. We need to have you back again. I've just been talking to Mr. Smith, who's a trusted trust attorney here in Tampa, Florida. We've been speaking for the last 26-27 minutes about trust. I've got so many more questions. Now, what time are you going to bed this Saturday night when I call you for my way in law ticket?
Well, you leave a message on my answering machine, and I will call you back.
How soon?
It depends on how much sleep I need.
For $394 million, how soon?
Well, I may not know that it's $394 million until I see the blinker on the phone. We actually had someone call who had won a $1 million lottery on the wheel in Las Vegas. And we helped coordinate how that got dealt with.
And how fast to set up a trust? Oh, wait, I'm going past my time here. Sorry about that. We need to have you on again.
Yes, sir.
Are you free to come on in?
I imagine we can work that out.
Okay. Again, my name is Al McCray, TampaNewsAndTalk.com. Tampa Bay's last place news. You heard it? Last place news. To reach me, 813-244-0664. And we're broadcasting at TBAE, Tampa Bay Arts and Education Channel in downtown Tampa. All my shows are available online at TampaNewsAndTalk.com and also on Spectrum Channel 635. And Frontier Channel 32. My shows online go back 8 years. Thanks again for tuning in. The previous episode of TampaNewsAndTalk.com was brought to you by...
Hi, I'm Pamela McCoy, CEO of Bonafide Credit Consultants. Our consultant team has nearly 30 years of progressive experience in the credit industry, to include credit card as well as banking. We have special expertise and have chosen to focus on personal money management, financial capability education, and credit management, critical assessment strategies, and we also do various trainings and sometimes using our clients' curriculum. So, and through these experiences, I decided to write my first book, Bonafide Bits, Where Inspiration and Intellect Collide with Your Finances. Now, this book is a quick, easy read, only 69 pages. It is sure to inspire, to encourage, and to bless every reader spiritually, intellectually, as well as financially. Now, this book was written for all people. It was written with all people in mind, whether you're female or male, young or old, or any ethnicity. And particularly, it would be of value to high school students as they build their financial future on a firm foundation. I believe you'll find the inspiration and financial principles that you can apply to your life immediately. Educate, empower, evolve, enlighten, and enrich every individual or group that we are blessed to serve. And when you apply these principles, you'll find financial freedom is right in the palm of your hand. So Bonafide Credit Consultants is your first choice to assist you with your personal money management needs. So, to fuel your financial potential, as well as be inspired, visit our website, bonafidecc.com today. That's BONA5DCC.com. Bonafide is proud to be a sponsor of TampaNewsAndTalk.com. Thank you.